Okay, hey guys, this is my other video of cable management with the stock holes of the Antec 900. This video, I'm gonna go over pretty much everything that I could think of to getting your cables managed pretty nicely with the Antec 900 without drilling. I just wanted to stay away from drilling, so yeah, this should help people that also want to stay away from drilling. Check it out. Alright, here is the biggest part. Excuse me, is the biggest part of the power supply right here, the main power. Same thing as all of them. Put it through the stock hole in the Antec 900, and luckily it barely reached right up to there. This is the power cable. So it just goes up behind and then comes back out on the top. This fatty wire right here. Can't even get at it. Right here. Right there is the power cable. And all it does is just go out, goes out, and then back in. This power cable for the motherboard, I mean, it's too short, you can't do anything to it. So I have to run it over the power supply and behind the graphics card, in between the graphics card and the motherboard, up to the top point where it is right up there. This is the only really in the open wire, but what am I gonna do, you know? It's the way it is. For the back fan to hide the cable, all I did was take it and hide it behind the motherboard. Make sure when you hide it, you don't want it to interfere with any of your ports. Mine's a little closer. There we go. And zoom in. And if you can see, it's really crappy. It just goes right behind the motherboard. And it's almost like I was looking through the motherboard. It goes through there. And it comes out right there. So it's just pretty straight through right behind the motherboard. It goes out to the back. And since it's really short, I have to put the power connector right at the top. Top fan's power goes right back there. And they both are right here, 1, 2, and the power is below them. For the top audio port up there, the cable, I ran it out the very top right here, and then I'm gonna take it and put it through this hole right here behind the power supply. You gotta make sure your power supply is all unscrewed and pulled out a little, or else you can't get back there. And you can see my light a little. There, right down there, is the cable. Now, since I'm using HD audio, I'm going to probably use HD audio, which is that one. I'm gonna plug it in. Little bastard. Alright, once you got it in, tuck your cables down really well behind the power supply. Check the back. I would recommend taking out, if you have, like, say, AC97 cord, I would recommend putting it out the back. Just so there's not anything more behind the power supply when you push it in. And then just push the power supply in. Nice and good. You barely can see anything. Doesn't even look like a cord. Alright, firewire. I don't need it, don't use it, will not use it, so I'm gonna tuck this to the back. I'm going to put it out the highest point of my case, just so it's the most hidden, since it's coming from the very top. This is for the front port. And here's the firewire. There's the top where it goes to the top. Bottom, just push it all the way to the back. And there's the firewire right there. I'll put this right here in a second. Everything's untied. This is the USB, the top USB cable, and that is right behind my main power cable. I put it to the back of the case. This is slack. I just wanted to show you what it looks like. See, there's the top, and just push it all the way back, and it's pretty much completely hidden. Not really, but it's hidden in terms of cable management. Here it is in the back, and the best spot to put this for my motherboard, the EVGA 750i, is right underneath the SATA spot, which is right there. Here it is poking out. Let's take it and plug it in. Right there. Push it and you can barely even tell. See, that's right now you got a clean case and you can look at that spot and there's not even a single wire in the middle. Except that guy, fuck that one. The 4-pin connector part of my power supply I hooked up to the back just because I thought I needed the most slack and length, so it is right there and goes right into the hole. You can see if I pull, it goes right into the stock hole. And it comes out right here. I put, since it was pretty long, I needed in the middle area. That was the only part, 4-pin, I needed inside the actual case.